Okay, as some of you have noticed, if you have upgraded to Adobe CC 2015, the new version, you will have seen that Plural Eyes version 3.3 or whatever the version is before 3.5 stopped working. I made a tutorial earlier about roundabout out of Premiere into Plural Eyes and then back into Premiere. If you go to the Red Giant website where Plural Eyes is, how do I connect Plural Eyes to Premiere? You will see this little note right here. And it says you cannot connect Plural Eyes 3.37 or earlier to Premiere CC 2015. You'll need to either upgrade to Plural Eyes 3.5 or manually exchange your project between Plural Eyes and Premiere. In other words, we're not going to allow you to do this anymore. And they give you a tutorial about exchanging it, but I figured I'd do it here too, because it's a little bit harder to get to this page and site is a pain in the neck to find, because you have to go to support and it's not in the thing, and they don't have any of the 3.5 even in, or 3.37 even in the support page. You have to go to 3.5 support, and it's a pain in the neck to even find this, even to get to this link. You can go to this link and see how to manually exchange it here. But I'm going to show you real quick how to manually exchange it. I mean real quick. This time, really quick, instead of 17 minutes like the last one that I did. So let's quickly go. I'm going to show you how to go. I just closed that page. Show you how to do this real fast. I'm going to click my sequence, file, new sequence, or control and N. And I'm going to call it Toasts. And now I'm going to go to drop my clips in. I've already got them clips ready to go. Keep existing settings because this was shot in 4K. On this audio is actually, the DJ didn't have a place to connect into the audio system at all, and I didn't have my mixer, so I just put my little wireless recorder mic over there near the speaker and then put this in the other room so I could hear it. Anyway, so I don't have a separate audio for this track, but that's okay. You still get the idea. And then the Nikon right here. So you get your two clips, plop them on the timeline. Now they're ready to go. This is one of the best speeches I ever heard, was the one by this guy. Anyway, you got your two clips, and if you had an audio track, separate audio, you'd have it down here. Works the same either way. Now, how you get this into Plural Eyes and back into Premiere is it takes a little bit of navigation. Export with the timeline selected. If you select a different timeline, it won't know which one it is. So you gotta have the timeline selected. File, export, Final Cut Pro XML. It's gonna save the project, and then it's gonna call it. See, it calls it whatever the name of the sequence is. So I've already done it to several of these. Click save. That's it. Now you go and you launch Plural Eyes. So let's go to Plural Eyes. You launch Plural Eyes. This is going to be really quick. I'm not going to show you how to edit or anything. I'm just going to show you how to do this. And you go to File, New Project from Premiere Pro. And then it's already here. Toast XML. You open it up. Now it brought in these two clips. And whenever you do the first one, you'll have to navigate to it. But after that, it'll constantly go the same one. So while you're on a project, try and do all the sequences in a row. And I'm just talking through this because it's importing the files with audio thing. Anyway, okay, so here we go. There's the camera. That's the main camera. You get this. This comes up when you 3.3 error. You get this when it says memory usage is high. It's higher than normal because there's 4K footage in here. Whenever there's 4K footage, it comes up with that thing. You just ignore it. Go to sync, level audio. I uncheck level audio because I don't like it to level audio. Try really hard. I do that anyway because sometimes the secondary audio is kind of quiet. Synchronize. There, it's synced. And if you had a third audio or another camera or anything in the other thing, you do it. Then you click export timeline. Just click export. It actually puts it right here. You can find it. Where are my exported files? By clicking here. But I know where they are because they're in the same. They're in a folder. I'll show you how to find them without having to even worry about that. So you just close this. You don't even have to save it. And then you go back to your project. Go to sequences. Click down the sequence thing and go File, Import, And then if you look here, it'll say toast exported. See, it says the name intro dances exported, ceremony exported. It makes a folder in here with the date and when you exported it. So click inside that folder and you'll see the toast XML file. Click open. And now it brings toast synced into here. See in the sequence? Double click it and there's your sync sequence. Toast synced. So now you can close the original and here have this. What I always have to do is right click and choose set the frame size or scale the frame size on my 4K footage again. Because it, for some reason, when it comes back in, it forgets that it needs to be resized. Anyway, that's it.